So it seems like Fallout 76's most recent patch, that with Locked and Loaded, has at least a couple of problems, one of which may just in fact be a complete game-breaking bug where your character is effectively unable to join the game. So in this video, I do want to go over some of these newly added problems on what is otherwise a really good and fun update. I think a lot of people have been enjoying it, and even some of the community frustration that has really sparked up around some of the responses given from Bethesda. But firstly, let's take a look at this Mannequin Bug, which again may be bricking entire characters. This really only started getting quite a bit of discussion over the past 24 hours or so. With the most recent update to Fallout 76 coming out this past Tuesday, mannequins were added to the Battle Pass as a rank 20 reward. And once you unlock these guys, you can place up to 5 of them down at your camp and assign armors and apparel to them, kind of like how mannequins work in basically every other game. But in the past 24 hours, we have now seen numerous reports of users getting what they're kind of dubbing a corrupted character as a result of using these mannequins in a somewhat specific way. So for some of the people impacted by this, they just can't actually join a game. As they try and join a game, they'll be immediately disconnected. For some others, they are able to join a game, but as soon as they do anything, move, drop an item, open their inventory, they are immediately disconnected. And these people are apparently just getting a traditional disconnected from server message, like when a server goes down or if you just lag out or glitch out. And what most of these reports are saying is that these users had 2 mannequins placed down at their camp with the same outfit on them. So with some people, they put down 2 of these, each of them got a dress, but it was an identical dress. Some other people had 1 in one room, 1 in another room, but the same outfit and armor piece atop of it. The super suspicious or interesting part about this being not many people have actually been able to recreate it, but it seems like more and more people are having this actual problem. So like for me, in trying to actually replicate this glitch and actually brick one of my own characters for testing, I've just tried simply having 2 mannequins down with the same outfit, same armor piece, tried having 5 mannequins down with the same outfit, I've tried having them in my shelter, out of my shelter, I've tried this on both my main and alt account in case it was something with having a ton of items on your account that would glitch this out somehow, and even one of the most important factors, I've tried spam assigning and unassigning some of these items to a mannequin, so having each of those mannequins wearing the outfit and just clicking assign and unassign really quick so the one mannequin has it coming on and off quickly. This is important because in some of these reports, it basically seems like people were trying to dupe using mannequins and got a corrupted character. And although that would be a nice way to tie a bow on this and be like, okay, so it's just people attempting to dupe that are corrupting their own characters, that's not a big deal. There's a couple of problems with that. One, obviously in my own testing using the exact same methodology, I was not able to recreate this. And 2, not all of the reports are like that, some of them being from a bit more of a trustworthy source. I'm sure some people are just lying, saying they weren't trying to dupe, even though they were. But for some players, it seems like they were just playing the game. They put 2 identical outfits on 2 mannequins, and then later on, they would do something, get disconnected from the server, and just be unable to rejoin, or every time they rejoined, they got this. And one of the reasons I really wanted to make this video now, and almost spread the word about this one, as to really not use mannequins, or at least not use the same outfit on multiple mannequins for the time being, is a lot of people are probably about to gain access to them. Like I mentioned before, this just came to the game with the update. You have to be level 20 in the season to unlock these. So if you're just a casual player playing normally, you probably haven't gotten to level 20 yet. But this week, I think a lot of people are going to gain access to mannequins, and we may see the rise of people actually breaking some of their characters in the process. But again, for the time being, it doesn't really seem like a simple one. There are numerous reports out there, but then also a ton of people trying to recreate this and doing so unsuccessfully. It definitely doesn't seem like it's as simple as placing down 2 mannequins and assigning outfits to them that are identical, but at the same time, maybe there's some kind of X factor around specific characters or the specific type of outfits being use that do cause this, and really is that simple some of the time. Bethesda is aware of this, but again, for the time being, I would avoid using mannequins. And likely over the next couple of days, we'll see more reports of this pop up, and hopefully some kind of resolution. Although, with that said, unfortunately, this is not the only issue to pop up with this update. Not even the only issue that's causing some issues with characters overall. Another pretty big problem actually comes around this new power armor bug that seems to have popped up. Where basically, when you're exiting your power armor in Fallout 76, you just kind of freeze in the animation of exiting the power armor. So you're kind of just stuck here. A lot of people, being frozen, do the natural thing and just exit the game, whether it be on consoles or on PC, closing it. Except it seems like this is making it so when you eventually do relaunch Fallout 76 and get back into the game, you're in a glitched state. The game thinks you're exiting power armor, so in turn it doesn't allow you to use things like your Pip-Boy or have access to any of your items. So a lot of people saw this and immediately were scared that they had bricked a character in a different way. Well, in reality, it doesn't seem like that's the case. If you actually just transfer out of your inventory fusion cores and the power armor pieces, it seems to fix this. Or if you do get stuck in this frozen state, you could just wait a certain amount of time and the power armor will be recalled to your inventory. It seems like the cause of this may have been the power armor exploit fix they just implemented. Since Fallout 4, there's been an exploit where, if you exit power armor near a wall, sometimes, if doing it correctly, you can just glitch through the wall. That was a thing in Fallout 76, carried over from Fallout 4, and they just fixed it. And it seems like that fix, with the most recent update, may have actually led to this most recent bug that's affecting some people when just exiting power armor normally. But then onto what is easily the most controversial of the fixes and exploits in the game right now, that with the meat cleaver exploit and the massive community backlash we're seeing around it. So the most recent update to the game added in this really nice quality of life feature where you can now bulk craft. As you go to craft something you can craft multiples of, you'll now have this slider where you can craft up to 255 at a time. Really nice, but it seems like in the process of adding this, Bethesda forgot to address the fact that meat cleavers actually disassemble for more than they cost to assemble. So what that means is you can have, let's say, a bunch of items, craft a bunch of meat cleavers, and when you go to then disassemble them, you will get back more items than it costs to craft them, and in this whole exchange, actually gain experience. So just by crafting and then breaking down meat cleavers, you would get wood, steel, and experience. Experience being the most important part to this, because you could stack this with a bunch of experience amplifiers and get a ton of experience, literally thousands of experience per second just by doing this really quick. Which in Fallout 76 right now, experience is valuable as it allows you to progress the season. There's this challenge in game where if you just gain a certain amount of experience, you'll register the challenge and progress the season slightly. So people were abusing this meat cleaver exploit, enabled by the fact that now you can bulk craft and bulk disassemble, and just completing the season in one day because they were gaining so much experience that it would finish the season. This was live for about 2 days following the patch, then Bethesda disabled crafting meat cleavers and several of the other items that were possible by this. Meat cleavers were definitely the most popular though, and now it is just no longer possible to abuse this in game. We don't really know what's going to happen to the people who abused it, the people that got to level 100 super quickly. Technically, abusing game mechanics is against the terms of service, so they could ban people, but they may just not bother. But this whole fix and disabling so quickly has actually angered the community quite a bit. And you might be sitting there wondering, well, why would fixing an exploit anger the community? And it's really around this tendency for Bethesda to be pretty quick about fixing exploits that hurt their money. So with the season system, it does, one, maintain active players, it gets people logging in every single day, and thus, for some of them, spending money on the atomic shop as they log in and check weekly what is added. But even further, you can use atoms, which cost real world money, but some you can get for free, to rank yourself up on the season. In particular, towards the end, a lot of people do this if they're not going to finish it. So this is viewed as another example of Bethesda being very quick and punctual about fixing or addressing a bug that is hurting the season system and hurting their bottom line. But bugs that don't hurt their bottom line just get neglected and exist for literally months or years. This is like a big problem with this game, where there are bugs that get added with a patch and just are there for 6 months to a year. One of the easy ones is the fast travel bug. You go to fast travel somewhere, you click on the location, and just nothing happens. Sometimes it's just one and done like that. Sometimes it takes several tries. This has been in the game for over a year. It got added by one of the patches. There was a challenge autocomplete bug. So Bethesda added in the season pass challenges that you have to complete to progress it, but there was a bug from before that where the challenges would sometimes auto-complete and you would get no reward. They didn't actually fix that bug before releasing the season pass, and the list goes on and on and on. There are a ton of lingering bugs or things that just should have been a quick fix that weren't and persisted for months, much to player frustration. So though on one hand, I could definitely see the perspective of, well, of course, Bethesda is going to quickly patch this out and address this exploit. It makes sense for them to do so. At the same time, the community is just frustrated that some of these bugs are going on for so long, and to see this dichotomy of treatment, where when bugs affect the money, they are quickly patched out in a couple of days, versus when bugs are just a nuisance to players, they'll be there for months or even years. Like with some of these, it wasn't even like the next update fixed it, it took several updates later for it to be addressed. And even on that note, what makes this a bit worse is there's actually a bug that was just added with this most recent update that makes getting experience in game now quite a bit more difficult. This has somewhat been here before, but seems to have just gotten worse with the most recent update. But basically in Fallout 76 right now, there seems to be an issue with enemies respawning. So at places like West Tech, the Burrows, White Springs Golf Course, and Blackwater Mine, after somebody comes through and clears out all of the enemies there, for whatever reason, now it is taking way longer for them to respawn. Like, you can server hop numerous times looking for this place to have enemies again, and it'll take you quite a while. You might just give up eventually. Which of course, now getting back to the battle pass, one of the ways you progress the battle pass is killing enemies and gaining experience. So now when some of your favorite grind locations that you typically clear, server hop, clear again, and so on and so forth aren't actually available because the enemies aren't respawning, this kind of compounds to become a larger or more frustrating issue for the community. It seems like this is probably related to daily ops. With the most recent update to daily ops, they made it so after they end, enemies no longer spawn there. And for at least some of these locations, it definitely seems like it existed even before this update. It just got more widespread with this particular one. Another issue with the most recent update, it certainly seems like weapons are breaking faster. It's not totally clear what's going on here. It seems to only be impacting certain weapons, but basically, yeah, they just break faster than they did previously. And one theory as to what happened here is it was an accidental revert of a past fix. During the testing for this update, some of the fixes were in fact causing bugs, so they were reverted, and this one may have been accidentally reverted with it. There's a weapon noise bug. This is not as big of a deal, but you probably notice it if you do a community event. Basically, some of those spin-up weapons are just making these really loud and obnoxious noises after the patch. Not really sure what's going on there. The friendly fire perk is just broken for friendly NPCs. So in the past, you could use this perk to actually heal up allied NPCs during some events. This was super valuable because the goal was to keep the NPCs alive. So you could heal them up, make the event a bit easier. It just doesn't work. This was reported and known during the PTS, and they of course know about it now. The map is just more zoomed in when you open the map. It's a really minor one, but kind of odd. They're aware of this one too. And lastly, one that seems to be relatively rare, but there are some reports of, is sometimes when you fast travel to a teammate, you'll actually get kicked from the server altogether. This is one of the ones I wanted to include at the end because I couldn't recreate it, but I've seen several discussions around it. But overall, clearly this most recent patch with Locked and Loaded definitely has some problems with Fallout 76, the mannequin bug potentially being one of the most egregious and one of the most problemsome. It'll be interesting to see what happens from all of this. I imagine if there is a big ban wave for anyone and everyone who abused the meat cleaver exploit, there'll be more pushback. But overall, yeah, I would avoid using mannequins. And honestly, even with that said, even with all these additional bugs, the update is still a ton of fun. I wouldn't take this as a complete reason to not try it. But of course, this is just another bad look for Bethesda. They are known as the buggy company. And when you have a bug list like this, and these are just some of the widely known ones, it doesn't help remove that status as a buggy company. With that said, I thank you all again for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope to see you all next time. Later.